Hey there, Royal Watchers. Guess what's brewing in the Regal corridors this time? We're diving straight into a spicy scoop from the Byline Times that's got everyone talking. It's all about some behind-the-scenes drama involving the Sussexes and a few high-profile names from the royal circle. So, buckle up, because this is one intriguing tale. Picture this. Dan Wooten and several royal households are caught up in a whirlwind of controversy. And guess who's at the center? None other than Prince Charles's right-hand man, Sir Clive Alderton, and Lord Peel, a close buddy of Charles. The plot thickens when these two advise Prince Harry to omit a certain Jones from the records. Why, you ask? Hold on, we're getting there. Now, this Jones character was under the microscope for allegedly leaking hush-hush royal info, but Simon Case, the private secretary to the Duke of Cambridge, did a deep dive and found nothing. Case, who's pretty tight with Jones, said the accusations were baseless, and Jones himself fiercely denied them. But here's the kicker. An anonymous whistleblower came forward with some juicy details. They pointed the finger directly at Jones and his partner, backing it up with some solid evidence, an internal accounting code from News UKZC snagged by a Sun administrator. This was big, so big that it got the attention of the Metropolitan Police and became a pivotal piece of a legal letter. And there's this little nugget from a statement shared with Nick Davies, a legendary retired investigative journalist. It goes something like, "I believe the publicist's ZC number is ZC634, but then it's all asterisks from there." Suspense, right? So, what do you think? Is there more to this royal riddle than meets the eye? Stay tuned as we unravel more of this regal mystery. All right, folks, let's peel back another layer of this royal saga. So my buddy tells me there's a bit of a money trail in this story. Get this. Around July 15th, 2019, someone allegedly coughed up $3,000 for a juicy piece about the Duchess of Sussex and her nannies. And that's not all. There was also a cool $1,000 paid for a story about someone's son. All this stuff was happening while the royal households were playing a high-stakes game of keeping things under wraps. Here's where it gets even more interesting. A well-connected source spilled the beans that Christian Jones's situation might just blow the lid off the secret dealings between the royal families and the press. You see, Prince Charles and Prince William's offices weren't too thrilled about this. They like to keep a tight grip on their image, and airing their dirty laundry in public? Definitely not on their to-do list. Now, even though Prince William seemed like Mr. Normal, the thought of their personal dramas getting splashed across the headlines was a no-go. There's a lot of back and forth between the big shot editors and royal reporters, all to make sure the coverage stays favorable, especially when scandals are brewing. The real twist? Harry and Meghan were seen as expendable in this high-stakes game, while the heirs and their better halves were untouchable. Harry's spot in the royal pecking order and his somewhat meager inheritance didn't do him any favors. Plus, with their rebel moves, Harry and Meghan were pretty much sidelined in the royal family. If they couldn't get back in line, well, tough luck for them. This whole debacle sent shockwaves through Clarence House and Kensington Palace, but Harry, he was dead set on digging up the truth. He couldn't shake off the feeling that their private info kept getting leaked left, right, and center. Stay with me as we dive deeper into these royal ripples. So, let's keep unraveling this royal tale. Harry was really irked by how the major newspapers, especially with Dan Wooten at the helm, were painting him and Meghan in a not-so-pretty light. Their plans to spend time abroad, which Wooten reported on, hit them hard. Interestingly, this wasn't a spur-of-the-moment decision. They even had the Queen's nod for a potential move to South Africa, though that didn't pan out. But here's where it gets juicy. It turns out Wooten might have been greasing the palms of someone with close ties to Kensington Palace. We're talking about a staff member's associate who had the scoop on Harry's family. Harry, not one to sit back, was on a mission to get to the bottom of this. Meanwhile, the royal households were in overdrive, trying to regain their grip on the narrative. Remember the transition funding from Prince Charles to Harry? It wasn't just about being a supportive dad. It was a power play to keep Harry and Meghan under the Duke's royal umbrella. But guess what? Harry and Meghan weren't having any of it. Now let's talk strategy. The Byline Times sheds light on how the royals juggle their media maneuvers. It's like a game of chess, with each royal having their own team and agenda. The end game? Protecting the monarchy at all costs. Charles and Camilla, they've been power players, even during the Queen's reign. Following closely are William and Kate. Any threat to this finely tuned hierarchy or the monarchy's image is a big no-no. Charles, sitting pretty at the top, is known for his hefty pride and his knack for keeping a squeaky clean image. How do they manage the messes? Media leverage. The royal offices are pretty chummy with the big shots in the press. It's all about playing the media game smartly. So, as we peel back more layers, it's clear there's a lot more to this royal puzzle. Stay tuned. So let's dive deeper into the royal media maze. When it comes to getting their message out, the royals have their favorite channels. They often opt for outlets like The Mail on Sunday and The Sun. Less frequently, they might turn to The Times and The Sunday Times. These papers are like the royal megaphone, broadcasting palace-approved briefings without much fuss. But here's where Christian Jones comes into play. His name popping up in legal documents was a big deal. It wasn't just about what he knew. The bigger issue was the risk of exposing the somewhat shady bond between the royals and the press bigwigs. Keeping Jones's identity under wraps was crucial to maintain this delicate balance. Now, this is where the plot thickens. The monarchy seemed to lean towards supporting the press secretary over Prince Harry. It paints the Sussexes as somewhat sidelined, doesn't it? It begs the question, are the royals, including the current monarch, manipulating things to put Harry and Meghan in a tough spot? Is there an underlying effort to make them look like victims while subtly discrediting the royal family? But hey, it's up to you to draw your own conclusions. I'm just here to lay out the facts and stir up some thought-provoking questions. And speaking of intriguing angles, let's talk narcissism. This story has shades of a power struggle between narcissists. Now, Dan Wooten wasn't officially tasked by The Sun to cover royal matters, but he started gaining traction in that area. It's like a chess game where each player is trying to outmaneuver the other. Who's the real puppet master in this royal drama? Stay with us as we delve into more of this fascinating narrative. So, let's zoom in on Dan Wooten's role in this royal puzzle. Back in 2018, while juggling his gig as The Sun's executive editor for Showbiz and TV, Wooten found himself increasingly drawn to royal stories. Fast forward to 2021, and he's making waves as the star presenter at GB News. Now, let's rewind to a particular piece. Wooten wrote on March 13, 2019. It stirred quite the pot with rumors of a rift between Prince William, Kate Middleton, and their Norfolk neighbors, David Rock Savage and Rose Hanbury, the Marquess and Marchioness of Kolmondeley. Hanbury was dubbed Kate's rural rival. But here's where it gets curious. The Sun pulled this article from their website, yet the story kept buzzing elsewhere. A former associate of Wooten dished to Byline Times about his shifting allegiances. Until around May 2019, Wooten seemed quite critical of Prince William, often commenting on his demeanor, but he didn't really take shots at Harry. Then, suddenly, in the summer of 2019, Wooten's tone changed. He went from being fixated on William to sharply criticizing both Harry and Meghan. This little insight into Wooten's shifting focus might just offer a broader perspective, but, as always, it's your call to make of this what you will. Now let's circle back to Harry and Meghan. They were seen as replaceable in this royal chess game, and there's this lingering issue of their private details being leaked without their consent. They've made their displeasure pretty clear. But here's the million-dollar question. Are their grievances genuine, or is this part of a calculated play for public sympathy? As we wade through these murky royal waters, it's evident that there's more to this story than meets the eye. What's your take on this unfolding drama? Stay tuned as we delve further into these regal revelations. As we wrap up this royal roller coaster, it's clear that power struggles are at the heart of the matter, particularly among those with narcissistic traits. It's like a high-stakes game where everyone's trying to outdo the other, making the royal circle a hotbed for intrigue and drama. So, there you have it. another chapter in the ongoing saga of the royals and the media, marked by shifting loyalties, strategic leaks, and a battle for public perception. It's a story that keeps on giving, with twists and turns that keep us all guessing. What's your perspective on all this? Do you see these developments as genuine concerns or strategic plays in a larger Game of Thrones? Your take on this could shed new light on the whole affair. Thanks for joining me on this deep dive into the royal world. Remember, the story doesn't end here. There's always more to uncover in the captivating and complex world of the royals. Stay tuned for more insights and revelations in the days to come. Until next time.